Hi guys, I'm pleased to introduce you our fellows. What's your name?
I'm Giacomo.
Luca.
Oh, nice to meet you. And where are you from?
I'm Italian.
I'm from Italia as well.
Pasta spaghetti, really good. And what are you doing now?
I am a PhD student.
Me too. We are working in the SUP&R project.
What is that? Can you tell me something more about it?
It is a European project funded by the Marie Curie Action.
In this project there are 12 of us and everyone is working abroad. For example, I'm working at the University of Granada in Spain.
Currently, I'm working at the University of Nottingham, and the common aim of all of us is to make both pavement and railways more sustainable.
Oh, really interesting. And, for example, what are you investigating?
Both me and Luca are working on railways, and especially I'm dealing with the optimization of design and maintenance of the ballast layer, that is a layer made of stones that support the railway.
I'm working on the subballast layer that is just below the ballast, and its main functions can be summarized in dwelling capacity and impermeability.
What? I'm not sure I can understand. Anyway, why are you doing this?
Because on one hand, ballast is really good because of its cost, maintainability and availability. But on the other side, it deteriorates really fast, so it needs a lot of maintenance to restore the track geometry. And in this sense, it increases a lot the cost of maintenance and the material consumption.
Because the conventional granular soap ballast presents some problems of impermeability and need high thickness for bearing on the structure. This means high consumption of raw material.
Right. Now I understand, I guess. So, what's the solution, or at least your solutions?
Currently, the research is moving towards solution for ballast stabilization in order to improve its performance and reduce maintenance. Unfortunately, the majority of them present some limitation related to cost and applicability. And because of this, I'm investigating stabilization by bitumen emulsion, which is a low energy technology with a relatively low cost and it's easy to apply.
Really interesting. And what about you, Luca?
It's new trend, the use of hot mix asphalt to replace the granular layer. These alternative solutions could be able to improve the bedding capacity and the permeability and at the same time reducing the thickness of the layer. However, the application of hot mix asphalt can lead to an important increase in construction costs and pollution.
Oh, I understand the problem. And how do you think you can improve it?
I'm citing two main solutions. On the one hand, the use of recycled material such as single-reclaimed asphalt pavement wrap and ground rubber for producing bituminous soap ballast. On the other hand, the reduction of the manufacturing temperature of about 40 degrees in order to reduce the energy consumption in the production.
Fantastic! So you are superheroes! Do you have something else to say to our friends?
Yes, remember.
Reduce.
Reuse.
And recycle.
Thank you very much, guys. And good luck for your projects.
I'm studying.
Is high maintainable and
of bearing the structures.
Currently the research is moving towards solutions.
Functions can be summarized in variability, bearing capacity,